Hello friends, my name is David and today we are talking about the Brayton cycle. In case of Brayton cycle efficiency, what we are going to derive that Brayton cycle efficiency is nothing but 1 minus 1 upon Rp raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma, where Rp is nothing but the pressure ratio. The pressure ratio means P2 divided by P1, or you can say P3 divided by P4. Why is it so? Because Brayton cycle efficiency is constant pressure process in case of combustion process and constant pressure process in case of exhaust process. This 1 to 2 indicate the compression process taking place, adiabatic compression process, in which the air is compresses. In 2 to 3, it is combustion process where heat addition process is taking place. In case of 3 to 4 process, it is expansion process where work done by the system. And 4 to 1 process is heat rejection process where heat is rejected at a constant pressure. Let's begin with the solving this, deriving this efficiency equation. Process number 1 to 2, it is adiabatic compression process. So whenever we heard about the adiabatic term, the adiabatic process having one equation which is T2 divided by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma is equal to V1 divided by V2 raised to gamma minus 1. So in this case we are using this equation T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So T2 is equal to Rp, means Rp means the pressure ratio which we are going to derive. So pressure ratio raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So T2 is equal to pressure ratio gamma minus 1 upon gamma into T1. So this is our first equation. The second equation is the process number 2, 3. It is constant pressure combustion process. Whenever we are not having an adiabatic process, whenever we are having a constant pressure process, at that time we need to remember the, or say recall the equation P2V2 divided by T2 is equal to P3V3 divided by T3. So according to that equation, by applying the P2 is equal to P3, what we are getting? V2 divided by T2 is equal to V3 divided by T3. So ultimately T3 is equal to V3 divided by V2 into T2, and we are knowing that what is T2? T2 is nothing but Rp raised to gamma minus 1 into T1. So I am ultimately, what I am doing? I am doing here T2 converting in terms of T1, over here T3 converting in terms of T1. So process number 3 to 4 now. In case of process number 3 to 4, which is adiabatic expansion process, again it is adiabatic process. Adiabatic process means the equation which you are need to use is T3 divided by T4 is equal to P3 by P4 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma is equal to V4 divided by V3 raised to gamma minus 1. So it is, if it is T4 there, then in equivalent to it, it's called P4 and it's equivalent to V3. It's a reverse proportional. So you can remember this equation in these terms. Okay, now we are taking here T4 divided by T3 is equal to P4 by P3 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. And as per the diagram, we are knowing that P4 is equal to P1 and P3 is equal to P2. I am applying over here P4 is equal to P1 and P3 is equal to P2. So P4 by P3 is nothing but 1 upon Rp and it is gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So T4 is equal to 1 upon Rp raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma into T3, taking T3 at the right hand side. And what is T3? T3 is V3 by V2 Rp gamma minus 1 upon gamma into T1. I am putting the value of T3 over here. instead of this P3. So what we are getting? We are getting T4 is equal to V3 by V2 into T1. Now applying the equation of the heat engine efficiency, it is nothing but 1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. Actually, the heat engine, if you are remembering the heat engine block diagram, then there will be one source, one sink, and in between there is a heat engine. Source means body at a higher temperature, sink means body at a lower temperature, source rejecting the heat, Q1 and Q1 amount of heat received by the heat engine, it done work of W amount of work and rejecting the heat Q2 to the sink. Sink means the body at a lower temperature. So in that case, the output is work and the input is the heat energy which is absorbed by the heat engine. So work done divided by output divided by input means efficiency. So output means work done and input means heat supplied means Q1. So output means the net amount of work or the cyclic integration of work is equal to cyclic integration of heat as per the first law of thermodynamics. So what is that? The Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1 means W is equal to Q1 minus Q2. And again divided by the heat supplied means Q1. So ultimately the equation would be 1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. Now Q2 over here is process number 4 to 1. Heat is rejecting from the process number 4 to 1. And it is constant pressure process, that's why we are taking the equation mcp T4 minus T1. And in case of Q1, we are taking the equation mcp T3 minus T2. Heat input is positive and heat output is negative. That's why we are here taking T4 minus T1. And here we are taking T3 minus T2. So ultimately MCP cancels out and 1 minus T4 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2 would be the equation. Now putting those values, instead of T4 putting V3 by V2 into T1, T1 as it is, instead of T3 putting the value V3 by V2 raised to RP raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma into T1, and minus instead of T2 putting the equation RP raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma into T1. Taking the T1 common out of it from the numerator and from the denominator RP raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma into T1 as a common, the remaining part is V3 by V2 minus 1 divided by V3 by V2 minus 1 should be cancelled out. T1 would be cancelled out. And what is remaining equation? It is 1 minus 1 upon RP raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So such kind of questions are asked for the 7 marks in the GTU examination. But the most important thing is why we are deriving this efficiency equation. Because in order to know how the cycle works as per the change in the pressure ratio. So in this case, if this value is higher, it means the sum value 1 upon RP will be the lower. If the RP value is increases, then 1 upon RP value will be reduces. And as the 1 upon RP value will be reduces, efficiency is increases. So as the pressure ratio increases, the Brayton cycle efficiency increases. That should be derived from this equation. But mind well, this is air standard efficiency where we are taking air as a fuel, not air fuel as a fuel. Actually, in the cycle of petrol and diesel, air and fuel are used, but for the sake of primarily knowledge or for the sake of simplicity, in case of engineering thermodynamics, only air standard efficiencies are going to be derived. I hope you learned this concept thoroughly. It is very simple cycle. Just you need to concentrate one thing, and that is convert each and every temperature in terms of T1. Keep in mind that you are able to solve Brayton cycle, diesel cycle, dual cycle, Otto cycle efficiency very easily if you are learning such basics. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.